In my view, the best way to look at the Bane case is to start with the fight with Stephen. Whether David or Robin was the killer, the plan was to kill the family as they slept. The executioner must have thought this would be the most painless and clinical way of carrying out the twisted task. It also ensured that no one would resist or cause difficulties such as running away. Asleep in their beds, and in the dark with no one about, that would have struck any determined killer as the best plan. But the plan went horribly wrong. The unthinkable happened. Stephen woke up and fought for his life. Desperate but injured, he was no match for his killer, who had sufficient strength to literally squeeze the life out of him with his own t-shirt. The violent skirmish may not have taken long, but it swirled around the room and hard objects were hit and toppled. Stephen fell or was pushed against a chest of drawers so hard that the handles on the drawers left their shapes imprinted on his back. His body sustained multiple bruises, scrapes, and cuts in the struggle. Blood from his superficial head wound and from the bullet wound in his hand went everywhere. After such a fight, the killer would not have escaped signs of a struggle. Blood on his person or on clothing, bruising, cuts, abrasions, and ripped clothing. This is why a comparison between the injuries on Robin and David is so important. Only David had the injuries and scratches consistent with a vigorous struggle. David had at least 3 bruises on the right side of his head and a graze below his knee, which just happens to look very similar to several abrasions on Stephen's body. The scratches or marks on David's chest, seen by 2 witnesses, are, in my opinion, almost conclusive of David's guilt.